What's the best option for insulating your exterior walls? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to discuss the best insulation for exterior walls. We're going to be talking about foam board, new wool, and spray foam. Before we get into that, please go below, hit that like button for us. Thanks. So first, we're going to be taking a look at new wool insulation. Now this will typically come in a roll or a bat. Now keep in mind, when you're using a material that comes like that, you're going to have to seal it in place somehow. We usually recommend can foam because it's an insulator as well as a seal. Some people may recommend other things like caulk or silicone, or even putting some type of netting up over top of that to hold it in place. There's a lot of options. They all kind of add some complication. And of course, it's adding a step on top of the insulation itself. Now, new wool, let's take a look at it for doing its job. It is a decent property for actually resisting thermal transfer. It does a good job at stopping heat. Now, when it comes to air seal, that's where it kind of falls short a little bit. Now, again, if we're going to use something like can foam that can air seal around it, that does help. But keep in mind, you won't necessarily have that true air seal that we're looking for inside that cavity. So new wool, it can definitely be a good option. And this could be a good DIY option if you consider yourself a handy person, you want to get that remodel done yourself, or if you want to do some of the work yourself on a new build that you're working on. So new wool, it is a good option for you. So next we're going to be discussing foam board for insulating those exterior walls. So this is a good option if you're looking at something that can provide an air seal but still is a DIY option for you. Now compared to new wool that we just talked about, foam board would be a better way to go for a lot of different reasons. One, it is an air seal. But keep in mind, you will still have a couple added steps. For instance, you will still have to seal around that foam board inside every cavity. One, you want to make sure it stays in place, but then you want to establish that air seal as well. Now, foam board by itself will be an air seal in the middle of the cavity through the board. However, that gap around the board, you want to make sure you use something, like I said, we recommend can foam because it's an insulator and an air seal to make sure that it's sealed off all the way around. Now, of course, you will have to do that in every single cavity, so it does add a couple steps. But if you're looking for a good DIY option for insulating those exterior walls, foam board could be a better way to go. So lastly, we're going to talk about spray foam for those exterior walls. Now, spray foam will be the best option in this topic. Now, we say that because one, it performs the job best. It does provide the best resistance to heat transfer through those walls. It also establishes that air seal as a one and done option. You don't have to add anything to it to get that total seal. Now, when you're looking at this compared to the other options like new wool and foam board, you lose the DIY option. Spray foam is really not a DIY option for you. You will have to seek out a professional contractor and have them out to do this install for you. And of course, spray foam will be the most expensive. However, if we're looking at this as compared to the other products, spray foam will by far be the best performing. So if you're looking for something that establishes that air seal throughout and it performs the best at stopping any moisture or air loss as well as heat transfer, spray foam is definitely going to be the clear choice for you. So now let's talk about all three of these products. So new wool can be a good DIY option. It is readily available for the most part, and you can get it ordered to you if it's not at a specific store that you're trying to pick it up. But it's a good DIY option and it can work as far as insulating your walls. And like I said, keep in mind, you will have to add some steps to that. Moving up to the next option would be foam board, where it does perform a little bit better and establishes that absolute air seal in the middle of the cavity. But keep in mind, you still have a lot of added steps, being that you have to can foam and or caulk around the entire board in every single stud cavity to make sure the air seal is throughout. Now we're jumping up to the best option when we look at spray foam. When we look at performance and overall efficiency and effectiveness, spray foam is going to be the best option for these. The only things to keep in mind is it will be more expensive than the other two, and you lose the option to do it yourself. You will have to get a professional contractor in to do that spray foam for you. However, if you're looking for the absolute best performing product, spray foam is the clear way to go. If you want to learn more about the best way to insulate your exterior walls, please click the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and ring that bell to see all of our notifications.